Welcome to the third and final part of our video. We are going to discuss about the features of the fiat bogie and its advantages. First, going through the transmission of vertical load and the tactile effort. The vertical load is transmitted from the coach body to the bogie bolster, then to the secondary suspension spring, then to the frame, then to the primary suspension spring, then to the axle box and the bearings, and finally to the wheel. Transmission of tractive effort from the LHB coach to the fiat bogie. It is done via the CBC and then to the underframe, then to the bogie bolster, then to the traction center. From the traction center, the tractive effort is transmitted to the traction lever and the traction rod. From the traction rod to the tubular cross beam, and then to the bogie frame. From the bogie frame to the control arm and the axle box. From the axle box to the bearings and the wheel. As far as the lateral energy control mechanism is concerned in a fiat bogie, it has an added advantage over the ICF bogie in the sense that it has control mechanism both at the secondary suspension level and the primary suspension level. At the secondary suspension level, we have a flexi-coil spring in a fiat bogie. The specialty about the flexi-coil spring is that it has a higher length to diameter ratio. This allows in the dampening of the lateral vibrations in a coach. The secondary suspension spring also has a feature that it has a rubber spring. It has a rubber spring, as you can see in this part, which does not allow the secondary suspension spring to get homed. Also, when the rubber secondary spring touches the bottom part, a bump stopper provided at the back of the secondary suspension spring does not allow the secondary suspension spring to get homed. Coming to the primary suspension level, the primary suspension level has a control arm which has a rubber silent block bushes which allow the dampening of the lateral vibrations. At the primary suspension level, we have a control arm which has a rubber silent block bushes which allow the dampening of the lateral vibrations, and also it allows dampening of the vibrations in the longitudinal axis as well as the rotational axis. An added advantage of the fiat bogie is the anti-roll bar. The anti-roll bar prevents the rolling motion of the coach. The rolling motion happens when the two secondary suspension springs are oscillating in out of phase motions. This anti-roll bar allows the spring to oscillate in the same phase. A feature of the fiat bogie is the tubular crossbeam. This tubular crossbeam utilizes the torsional motion, the torsional properties of a hollow cylinder. This allows the fiat bogie's frame to be flexible. This helps in filtering out the track irregularities. One of the many features of a fiat bogie which allows the travel at high speed is that it has vertical dampers which are 4 in number in the primary suspension level, 2 vertical dampers at the secondary suspension level, and 1 lateral damper. And 2 yaw dampers, one on each side of the bogie. An added feature of the fiat bogie are 2 bump stops, which are longitudinal bump stop and the lateral bump stop. Another component provided with the fiat bogie is the corner roll. They are provided at every corner of the coach
that is two in numbers in each bogey. It prevents excessive cornering of the coach.